There was a time when people could only print in 2D, boring things like homework or invoices. But now we have a new technology that allows us to metal 3D print so we can make more important things like keychains and bottle openers. Well, actually, metal 3D printing is really useful for aircraft parts and artificial hips. And the technology is growing in efficiency and popularity. It's surprisingly simple and it works like this. A laser melts metal powder into any shape you want. It starts with a metal base plate inside a build chamber. A scraper moves back and forth, putting down a thin layer of metal powder. A laser then melts this powder only in the spots where your object will be. The scraper then moves over the base plate again, and the process is repeated. Layer by layer, your object is created. Think of the process like making lasagna, but with lasers. Hi, my name is Svan with Holocreators, and now let's look at SLM in more detail. SLM is an acronym for Selective Laser Melting, and it's one of the technologies behind metal 3D printing. The metal printing bed surface needs to be the same kind of material like the object that you want to print. So if you want to print in titanium, then you need a base plate that is titanium as well. And if you're really fancy, I mean, you could even print in gold, but make sure to send the 3D print to my home address so I can verify its authenticity. I already told you how the metal powder is scraped over the base plate and then melted by the laser. The tray is then lowered by 0.03 millimeters and another layer of powder is added. Layer by layer, the object is created. If the object has more than 45 degrees overhang, then a support structure should be added. This is because even though the part is fully immersed inside the metal powder, its own weight drags on the part and it would sag and deform if not properly supported. Kind of like a donkey that gets sad if all the weight is only on one side. By the way, if anyone knows something that's benefiting from sag, write it in the comments and I will get you a prize. After the lasers have completed the 3D print, the metal powder needs to be removed. And also it needs to be cut from the metal base plate. You can use wire EDM for that. That's a technique I covered in another video. And then also you need to remove the support structure, which can be quite a lot of work. And you need angle grinders and all kind of edges to like remove the support structure. Here's a nice video clip of before and after view of a part with and without the support structure. You may ask yourself, what are the advantages and disadvantages of metal 3D printing compared to CNC milling? Or you may ask yourself, when I'm finally going to show you how to metal 3D print a bottle opener. Let me explain. First of all, you can metal 3D print any object you can think of. Undercuts are no problem. Also, you could vary the density of the material during the print. So a part could be more rigid in some areas and more flexible in others. Disadvantages are that metal 3D printing takes a very long time. So about 30 to 40 hours for one build chamber. So that's as long as the average chat with your mom. But as I said, Rome wasn't built in a day and 3D prints aren't either, so a day and a half isn't so bad. Another downside is that the surface quality of the metal prints is very rough when they come out of the printer. So I have an aluminum 3D print here and I will zoom in a bit and you can see the roughness of the part. And in CNC milling you don't have this, so I mean you could do some post-production on this and now put this into a CNC mill and clean it up, but straight out of the printer it looks very rough. Also, the accuracy of the 3D printer is not as high as what you get out of a CNC mill. So you have on average about 0.2 millimeters deviation between your original file and the 3D print. I hope you enjoyed the video, and make sure to tune in next time when I talk about some other fascinating topic. Please subscribe to the channel if you like, and well, see you next time. Bye-bye.